Polling shows the president still has a 91% approval rating among African Americans. A Gallup poll published last month shows, though, just 25% of black voters are thinking about the midterms compared to 42% of white voters. Let's bring in the Reverend Al Sharpton, president of the National Action Network. It's good to see you, Reverend.
Good to be here.
So how does he do that? Look, we know that African Americans still love the president, but they're not thinking in terms of getting out to the polls in numbers as large as many other groups of voters have been thinking about it. So how can he change that dynamic?
Well, I think the way the president and the DNC change it is to talk about this process that we started in 08 with a new president, with a new vision, not just for African Americans, but all Americans, but including our interests because we are disproportionately impacted. We can't do with one vote. This is not like going to a cafeteria where you pay up front, you vote once, and you walk down and get whatever you want. This is a process you've got to continue to be involved in, and I think that we are beginning to hear that message. The radios, the churches, the social groups are beginning to do it. I spoke last night in Atlanta, Georgia, at Morehouse College, and those young people were fired up because they're beginning to understand that you can't vote one time. You've got to vote in the midterm. You've got to have the Senate and the Congress to help push the things through that all Americans want.
Were they fired up because I've seen you in those situations? You're a speaker who gets people fired up. Or were they fired up to go to the polls?
Well, I hope I helped them to do both. I mean, I think that clearly they the fact that it was a packed house tells me there's an interest there. And I think that those of us that are going out there, whether it is with the DNC or whether independently with groups like National Action Network that are nonpartisan, we're saying we've got to come out and vote. Whatever you're going to do with your vote, you've got to vote. Clearly, the Democratic Party's got to say you've got to come out and give us and keep us in the majority if we're going to get health care, if we're going to get the reforms you want, and if we're going to deal with jobs.
Give us your best estimate of those 91% of black voters who still support the president. What percentage are we going to see go to the polls in November 2nd?
I would hope we see 60% or more. That's high, but that's my hope. I think right now we're a little lower than that, but I think that these last 3 weeks, you know, sometimes in home stretches where the miracles happen, and I think we can see the Republican Party face a surprise by not picking up everything they think they will if the people come out, not just blacks, but the people that really want to see this country keep going in the right direction.